Hey everyone, welcome back to the HWBOT World Tour 2016. We're here in Europe at Poitiers at the Gamers Assembly, the biggest LAN party you can have in France, over 1800 gamers here. And we are having the HWBOT World Series Final. This is the MSI OC Academy first semi-final. Two of the amateurs will compete today in XTU. 2 times 15 minutes. The scores of XU will be added to each other to have the final result in the ranking. We will be soon tuning in the venue to check with the judge if everything is alright. The judge for this first competition will be Timothée Tiala from HWBOT, and he will be giving the start round, and everything will go on for 15 minutes. Let's check if we can hear Timothée.
I can hear you.
We can hear you. So let's say who is Dark05. That's the person on your left.
Okay, so Dark05 is this person here.
And here the we second have one Pickaa. Is Pickaa.
Yes.
So let's get to it. They will have 15 minutes. The timer is ready. Timothée, it's whenever you want to go.
Okay. Vous êtes prêts? Ready? 3, 2, 1. Go, vous avez 15 minutes.
So we're off for something totally different now. Before we saw the extreme guys go bench hard, and this is like something that you can do at home on your daily setup. So they're like running Intel Extreme Tuning Utility, a free downloadable software from Intel itself. So only, of course, valid for Intel CPUs, not doable on AMD. But the thing it does is like it really stresses your system hard. That's CPU, memory, subsystem, and we have talked about it last week as well during the South Africa tour. The thing is, this is like a really nice stability testing tool that you can use at home. So these guys have been taught like yesterday, how many minutes of overclocking?
30 minutes.
30 minutes of overclocking, so they're already like getting a feel of what they can do,
how
they can
do it. Oh, the first blue screen! This is the first blue screen of the semi-final by Dark05, and we have to admit, we have to present Dark05 is only 12 years old.
Really? Wasn't there like an age limit for these things? No?
We didn't put any age limit so far, so he was still able to compete. He had to come back and he came here with his mom to try to do this. So as you can see, this overclocking thing is very accessible to anyone. On the other side, we have a Pickaa. That is here, that is actually going at 4.4 right from the beginning.
So did we have already our first score in? 1,096 points by Pickaa. So Dark05 indeed just back in the system and trying to get it run. So the thing that we can do here in fact as an XTU, they don't need like other software tools from MSI or go really into the BIOS. They can, let's say, adjust all the multipliers and the voltages that they need inside the tool. So indeed, like I said, something you can try perfectly at home and just see how high you can tune your setup. Most important, in fact, it's always when you're testing stability is you have to check certain values. Monitor your voltage, of course, but for daily stability, make sure that you always keep your CPU temperatures, let's say, within a safe zone. So if we're looking at the screen of Pickaa at the moment, his package temperature is in fact is what the CPU temperature is all about, is around, let's say, 50-ish degrees. And it's only cooled by a single fan, a liquid cooler. So not really a true high-end setup. I don't know. Ah yeah, he raised the frequency already from 4.5 up to 4.6 gigahertz. So we'll see a slight improvement in score. And that's what we have. We have 10 points increase of to 1106. Maybe I can already answer the question of Benny Yee. What is the objective in this competition? So Benny, in fact, the only thing that they have to achieve is like pull off a higher score for this benchmark that they're running right now than the other one. That's all that there is to it. Just be number one, be the fastest. There are also benchmarks which, of course, need to do like a faster time. So in that case, the lower the time is, the better the score. This case, just XTU, highest score wins. The interesting format of this competition is also time pressure, but they will swap systems. So let's assume that our young friend there has not like that good CPU, he will have the opportunity to bench on the faster platform after 50 minutes and maybe can catch up. of course, the only thing that they don't know is from each other is how high did the CPU ran. So we just missed the blue screen, Truth, on your right.
I was leading that one to you.
And
I love the amateur because there's so many blue screens because that's still on the edge, but not far, as far past the edge like the extreme overclockers.
Yeah, indeed. But it's also that they have not also all the knowledge, but we can like already guide them like already on the way to get like into overclocking. And it's like we said, you can boost the performance of your setup just at home by changing a simple multiplier, maybe a slight increase in voltage. You get like a 20% improvement on the clocks. Not saying 20% improvement in total, let's say, system speed and performance, but you can boost all these KSQ CPUs of Intel at least 400 or 500 megahertz easily. Performance that comes for free, isn't it?
We are here, so both of these overclockers, Dark 05 and Pickaa, are back into XTU.
And the interesting part is like he's trying to raise the reference clock a lot. That's one first, I think. So he's trying, instead of going straight via the multiplier, he's going straight via the P clock, which is interesting because usually these amateurs only work with the multiplier and raise voltages. So maybe he got some inside information somewhere that raising the P clock also increases the memory speed, which can maybe ultimately lead to a higher score.
Depends on who was teaching him in the workshop as well.
Yeah. Indeed.
That's it. We have 5 minutes already gone in this first leg of the semifinal for the amateur. So there's 10 minutes left for them to set a score. So far, Pickaa have a score of 1106.
This is also like straight elimination.
So the winner of this match will go to the grand final. And okay. There is no small final for the amateurs. The total amount of points will decide who is third or fourth.
So both platforms running now.
Oh, blue screen.
It wasn't even that high on frequency at this moment. Temperatures were like really low and still it crashed. So he needs to figure out now with the limited knowledge that he got or received yesterday when he was like tutored to figure out why is this happening?
A new score from Pickaa, 1121, improving his base score. Let's hope that Darkofi can still manage to get a score. We went to talk to him and he was super stressed before. That's the first time he's competing in any kind of competition. That's the first time he's actually coming here to the Gamers Assembly. And we have to say, this kid have a lot of, you know, of guts just to come here and participate in the competitions. He definitely deserves a big round of applause just by being here. Congratulations.
Yeah, indeed. Of course, he had to convince his mom, of course, to drive him over again and just to get in there and try to run it. So let's see what he is up to now.
So going...
Indeed, straight going again for the base clock. Because if you had like sort of strategic plan, you would just go slowly on the multipliers, up the volts and see how the relevance is with the temperature and the score output. But he just, yeah. Probably also might be a little bit limited on the volts that they taught him yesterday. Maybe go 1.35-ish, like he's setting now. Turbo boost slider to max. A new score by Pickaa, 1122. So he raised one single point. 41 multiplier. Setting it, and he's trying to run it probably soon. Going straight 43. Don't hear your truth.
He did 104 in the reference log and then he did 43 in the multiplier. It's a lot of settings being changed at once. That's definitely not something we see usually from the amateur because we always try to explain them like go one by one. It's actually easier to go this way and find out what is working or not.
Indeed, that's also a thing that we can advise to anybody watching at home doing like his first steps in overclocking is go with small steps. Learn how your system reacts, learn how it feels, watch temperatures. It's not always needed that you have to blue screen. I'm just doing a little Truthman impersonation, but I'm not that good at it, so I'll leave it to Truthman next time. But when go overclocking, just go small steps, small voltage increases, watch temperature. Very important for your daily setup. And I think the best test for daily setup, of course, is just using the PC what you tend to use, either being a 3D benching or even just gaming, rendering, whatever it does. That's where the fun is. Can you increase performance?
Okay, the first core of Darko 5 is soon to happen, and this is it. 1096. It's not the best core so far, but it is a score that is can it be improved in the next 6 minutes of this first leg.
Yeah, the DD is like still way lower in frequency than Pickaa. So if he can match it, he still increases the B clock. So I think somebody gave him really the tip. Increase the B clock, memory speed goes up, and your efficiency will go.
Blue screen for the red team. This is hard because he just managed to get the first core out on this semi-final, and he's already out with a blue screen. Losing some precious second, restarting and everything, take times.
Indeed, maybe his setup is not as good as the one from Pickaa, but I don't think they taught him like the profile thing at the XTU. So maybe it would have been better that we teach them next time if we have like a good score, that you save the profile. So you can start again from that one and slowly increase. Maybe the tutors forgot that one. But it's like we said, we only have like limited time with these people. They have like a lot of questions usually. And you can't like think about everything. Due to the limited amount of time, usually we don't go into the BIOS and start about X and P and all that stuff. Just the basics, really the principles. Up the multiplier, up the volts, check the temps, run. Pickaa running again. And now at 4.66 gigahertz. So we should see an improvement in his score. Darko 5, at it again. Adding the same amounts of volts, so he's been taught to not go over it. Pickaa almost finishes his run. Will it beat 1122 or not? Ooh, a little bit lower, 1119. Darko going for it. His mom is like really watching him. I have no clue what my son is doing, but he seems to like it. Just let him have fun. This is also usually one of the things, Truth. Know that we have like when people are watching, like what are they doing? What are these guys about? If you guys have any questions, please feel free in the Twitch and we'll try to reply to them in the ways we can do it.
So Pickaa is benching at the moment, the blue team Pickaa, the one on the left side of the small camera on the side. Soon to have a score, he's benching at 4.66 GHz, almost 4.7 GHz. 1.3 volts for the core voltage. Didn't change much of the other settings so far, just pushing the turbo to the maximum.
And this is like you're really seeing the difference between the two setups now at this moment. So Dark 05 is like 300 megahertz less, and his CPU in fact is having or reaching already a higher temperature than the other one. And this is also something that is typical in when you do overclocking. You can buy like 10 different CPUs and all will have like different voltage requirements, different temperature outputs. And it's also, you can never compare it. If you buy with two friends the same setup, it could be that one overclocks just higher than the other one. It's, yeah, lucky draw. We call it the silicon lottery. We've talked about it again.
1083, not improving his score, but still a decent score so far. The processor didn't go above 4.34 gigahertz. So if he's touching the multiplier, he always want to go to the base clock. It's impressive. Yeah. And if he's using the multiplier more, he might have better chance to actually just catch up on Pickaa's score.
I think he heard you because he's just touched the multiplier.
So now he's at 4.5 gigahertz running the benchmark again. At the same time, we have Mr. Pickaa benching at 4.67 gigahertz.
Yeah, he's staying like a little bit limited over there. So even though the temperatures look quite good, maybe they got really the instruction, 1.35 volt is it? And he's still like hovering around the same score all the time, 1119, 1122. So no improvement there at the moment. Darko 5 in his run should be able to easily beat his previous score as he's 100 megahertz more.
There's less than 2 minutes in this first
and it crashed.
Semifinal.
It locked up.
Yeah, the system from Dark 05 just crashed, sadly.
That's the thing. I'm really surprised that during all these World Tour events, you didn't have like any single hardware failure on motherboard and CPU.
Not a single failure for more than 400% that passed by the systems.
So that's pretty awesome. I think many manufacturers can use it. Like, our board survived the HWBOT World Tour without any losses.
That would be quite an advertisement as well. Huh?
Yeah. So both guys are really like at the end of their wits at this moment. Like, all their efforts seem to be like effortless at this moment.
And we are 1 minute to the end, 55 seconds now. So let's see what Darko5 can do with this system. We will cue in the judge, Mr. Timothée.
Yes.
There is 40 seconds left in this first semifinal.
40.
Did that pause? We have Pickaa restarting the system. He's still in the lead, so far it's not very stressful. But we have Darko5 going hard on the core voltage once again.
What did he apply, in fact? How many volts? Still at 1.35.
On the benchmark. That would be a very tough and tight battle. There's 2-1. Oh, this is it. The benchmark is not launched for Pickaa, so Pickaa cannot submit any scores. Only Darko5 could, but sadly, the system crashed. So, it's over. Timothée, congratulations for the first leg.
Bravo, donc on va changer de côté. Vous asseyez chacun de l'autre côté, vous touchez pas au PC, on va les remettre par défaut.
So we will be resetting all the system and queuing back to our judge. So the systems have to be reset in order to have a complete fairness in between the two guys.
Yeah, of course. It's like you said, you have the score, and usually with the score you can also load in all the settings of let's say the previous overclocker over there. Probably they have not told that to these guys, but sometimes we learn as well from our mistakes. We had also a similar small event, not linked to HWBOT, but at a certain moment we forgot the profiles and one guy said, oh, what's this? And he just loaded the profile and he was like, whoa, I'm getting like a very good score. But even Tim is going into the BIOS and doing like a default again.
So we are having the first match for this MSI OC Academy Final. It's Pickaa against Darko5. The second match will be Exmrk and Estepp. Each of the winner will move on to the grand final. They have to do 2 times 15 minutes. They have to do XTU score. And the both score are actually added to each other in just making sure that everything will be fine and everything is fair for both of these people.
Indeed. This was also a thing they did like at DreamHack, I think, but with Liquid Nitrogen. Were you guys also present at that moment? I still remember that Peter Jan went head-to-head with Elmore, and Elmore had like a really good running setup, and Peter Jan was struggling, and then they switched, and sadly he couldn't like reach the clocks of Elmore at that moment. So it's not always the same. You still have to have like a little bit of luck, the knowledge to go.
Thank you guys for tuning in here on our Twitch.tv channel, OverClocking-TV. We are streaming live the MSI OC Academy Final here at the HWBOT World Tour at the Gamers Assembly in France. And this amateur will be competing today for the first place here to be the champion of the MSI OC Academy. So the judge already, let me cue in to Mr. Timothée. Timothée, can you hear us?
Yes, I can hear you, Chief.
Are the overclockers ready?
So Dark is ready, Pickaa is just restarting, so Intel XTU is recovering from the previous crash, so just gotta wait a little bit for that. Okay, so I'm gonna open it and it's all good. So just closing it again, so they're both in desktop. Est-ce que vous êtes prêts?
We are ready to go here.
Okay, so round in 3, 2, 1, go.
And they're off again.
Off to it again, 15 minutes.
Let's see if they indeed do the same, probably the same tactics as they did before. Will they try to go a little bit higher? That would be the thing. Boy, both in the Intel XTU. Applying the same settings, 4.5. Let's see if he can run this one. 4,500 megahertz now running. Dark 05 was not able to do that on his setup, so Pickaa took the one over. It's still running. So he had done some small setting which was making it able to run while Dark 05 was not able to do it. Let's see the scores. 1122 was the best score. Let's see if Dark 05 can
there's
match
actually
that one.
A little glitch. The red is supposed to be blue and the blue is supposed to be red. That won't be long, guys.
Okay.
There you go. You have the right screen for the right person.
Okay.
So the blue screen is always Pickaa and the dark of ice is always the red screen.
Okay, cool. Let's see what Pickaa pulls off. The best score, Dark of 5, just below.
1082, so it is using the system that Dark of 5 was using just before. It's already scoring like 10 points just below the best score of Dark of 5 from the previous one. Oh, and it's a blue screen!
So indeed, he's facing the same problems that Dark of 5 had, in fact. At a certain frequency, it just doesn't want to run anymore. So either they need to have more volts. He really needs to apply more volts to get it like running again. But of course, he had already like a score, so he can add that to his other score and go to a way higher total. So Dark of 5 really needs to surpass 1122. But now it's fine. If he does even less than 1122, he will still have like a higher total.
He has more points than before, so he is actually in the lead. So what does Dark of 5 have to do is to actually score much higher than what Pickaa did with the same system.
Yeah. But that's really interesting, in fact, because I thought in the beginning like they would just, let's say, add the points and then take the average. But this system is even way better. It's way better. We really have to match the total. So indeed, we see Dark of 5 doing a safe run, I think, if we can consider it like that.
Still, it's a decent run.
Decent score, but he needs to go over 1100 to be able to win this one and go on to the finals for the amateur overclocking competition here.
So Pickaa is changing some of the settings, trying to go at 4.5. On the other side, Dark 05 is at 4.5 as well.
Let's see if you can pull this off. What happens?
No, it's at actually Dark 05 is at 4.2 only. So 1082 point again. 1082 point. So we will have to continue pushing it. It's still the same. It's all always going straight for the base clock.
Yeah.
For the base clock. Pickaa is restarting the system.
We have to ask who was his tutor yesterday. Who told him that?
Yeah.
But indeed, it's not a bad strategy because this benchmark really scales with memory speed and timings. Okay, they will not adjust the timings, but if you can get like a higher memory speed, it will give them like an additional 10 or 15 points, which is needed at this.
Oh, the system crashed. So XU crashed while trying to bench for this MSI OC Academy semi-final here between Dark 05 and Pickaa.
But you directly see that these guys are like used to working on a computer, like the system just crashed, they like stay cool, just close the application and relaunch it again, no problem. Reboot it and we see like a lot of crashes at this moment. Max there, core voltage, how much?
So still at 100 reference clock, trying to put the core voltage at 1.2. Come on, you can push that one higher. You can push that one a little bit higher.
Yeah, it's no problem.
I think it can go until like 1.32 maybe. We'll see.
1.35. They did. It's weird because Pickaa did a run on 1.35 on the other setup, and now he's like going lower in volts just to see if it still runs. It's not a bad...
They are all using the same hardware, of course, and they are using the Z170A X-Power Gaming Pro Carbon from MSI, of course, the Clef Crass Memory Kit, a Core i5-6500K, if I'm right, and they use all the Seasonic 760 Watt PSU, the Platinum Edition.
Yeah, that's really impressive because it's not one of their high-end models of, for Seasonic, but still the LN2 overclocker, so the Extreme guys using the same power supply as well.
Yeah.
So pretty solid PSU to have in your daily setup as well.
Definitely solid. Here on Pickaa, we can see that the package temperature, so that's the CPU temperature, is still there's still some margin. We're just at 50 degrees. There's no thermal throttling happening, so the CPU reducing its own frequency because it's too hot. So there's still margin in this to happen, and that's 1082 again, same point again, points. Scoring the same point.
Yeah, he really needs to get again at the 4600 ish speeds to go like higher at 4.5.
There's one thing as well. These guys playing with the reference clock are although increasing the graphic frequency while doing so. Mm-hmm. Do you think that could be possible?
Yeah, it's all a little bit linked, but the thing is like...
Oh! Blue screen! Two blue screen in a row! That's the double blue screen that we just had right here.
It was almost happening at the same time, which is like... It's like you said, you promised me we would see a lot of more blue screens with the amateurs. You were right, man. And it's also like they're going real safe, and maybe it's not a bad thing if you have to do this for daily overclocking. Now they're like in sort of competition, but indeed for daily overclocking, maybe just limit to a specific voltage and don't get too carried away when doing so.
Here at the first semi-final of the MSI OC Academy, there's 8 minutes left in this first semi-final between Draco5 and Pickaa. So far, Pickaa is in the lead. We do expect Draco5 to put out a good score as well. So XCU is trying to recover from the previous crash. Or you can see that Pickaa, he knows what he want to do now. He's like going for the voltage, the core voltage. Just imply I break that one as much as he can.
Yeah. Just trying to figure out why it crashed. But I usually think it's not enough voltage. But he's going lower. Maybe he's right. Maybe he found something new with Skylink that we're like all doing wrong. Could be. But he tries again a 4.5 run. So he should be able
to... Oh, there's a current limit throttling kicking in for... that's actually quite interesting to see. So the current limit throttling means that the CPU is using too much power?
Yeah, and it probably will not run like full blast as well. You see also the core frequency like starts to jump around, and that's something especially during these runs that you don't want to have. You want to have stable, rock stable CPU frequency all the time. So he probably forgot something there.
Let's move out the ranking, and you can see that the orange line on the screen, that's the core frequency, and this one is like going up and down between 4.3 and 4.4 when all of these settings are at 4.5. So this is like a safety measure from the processor itself to not end up burned. We do have the same behavior on either Pickaa or Draco5. We have a little less of throttling, but still, like 4.1 gigahertz, 4.15 gigahertz. It was at just a little bit below that. It's almost default.
Yeah.
This is almost default.
There's indeed no need to raise core frequency or core voltage indeed to reach these clocks. But of course, you have to think now they're performing this at all the cores. So Intel CPUs have like this what we call the turbo speed. The turbo value that changes depending on the load, how many cores it loads, that it could go, let's say, up 400 megahertz higher. If they're like two cores, it could go like 300 megahertz higher above the stock speed and so on. So this is indeed something that you really need to avoid during this. So changing the voltage.
Reducing the voltage. No, go the other way. That's the other way you should go. But as you know, maybe the current limit's like, oh, maybe my voltage is too high. But you might have found what is the issue, Ligovs. Can you share your thoughts with the people on the live?
Yeah, they have these sliders here, and there's like turbo boost limit and stuff like that. If you go into the screen again, and these were the sliders that they were moving all the way to the right. Turbo boost power max, turbo boost power time window. They were just like increasing those. And this is what happens usually when you're like under pressure, that you're forgetting certain settings. It happens with the amateurs, which is like logic, but it also happens with the extreme guys. And at a certain moment you were like thinking like, Why are you doing this? Why are you doing this? Like, you should be booting straight at this frequency into the Windows, and now you're like upping in Windows. And it's like, yeah, people can forget. And Pickaa is really forgetting to
Now you found it. Now you found that he had to raise the turbo boost power max limit for it. Maybe he heard you on the live, I don't know.
He speaks good English though then. Or he understands English.
Yeah. Not quite sure. So this is now you can see it's running the benchmark at 4.5 GHz. There's no current limit throttling kicking in. So the maximum power limit is basically like a safety measure in a way. It have to be below that limit for the CPU to increase its operating frequency. So that's where you actually push it to the max.
Indeed. Usually by doing the extreme overclocking, you could care less. Everything is maxed out and you disable all the power saving features in the BIOS. But these guys haven't touched the BIOS. So Intel XU still allows you to tweak, let's say, all these voltages and wattages inside the tool itself. So indeed, no current limit throttling now. And we will probably see like a slightly better score, hopefully, for Pickaa to raise even his total. Darko 5 still needs to catch up.
He seems a little bit lost inside his bench, but Darko 5 is still going on. The score from Pickaa was not that great. So there's only 3 minutes and 10 seconds left in this second leg of the first semi-final. Let's see what can be done here.
Maybe Tim can do like a small interview on them, how they felt after, like, let's say, these 30 minutes of fame. It's not easy, I think. You're like performing under pressure. You're doing something which you're not acquainted to, like on a daily basis. And then just go here for a live audience being streamed as well. And what can they win, Truth? I have no idea about the prizes.
So the first winner of this amateur competition will win a PSU, of course, from Fictonic, the exact same one they're using, the motherboard they're using, the Z170A Gaming Pro Carbon, a Clave Crash Memory Kit DDR4, of course, and one of the special BC1 Open Vegetable Special HWBOT World Tour 2016 edition. There's only 12 of them in the world. This is the very special, it's still a prototype, but we wanted to offer that to the few people that do participate in the competition.
They can't take it home right now, I think.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
So you will have, again, for next event, you only have 10 bench tables available.
Yeah.
And then.
Yeah.
Then that's you ran
all,
out.
That's all new prototype all the time. The second place will you win a PSU. There's 2 minutes left. So the second place will win a PSU from Seasonic. The motherboard was from MSI. And the third place, we go home with a PSU and a memory kit.
Yeah, still decent prices, in fact. You get, besides the CPU, you get like a solid gaming setup on the latest generation of Intel hardware.
You can see that Pickaa is relaxing just by the time the benchmark is completing. Oh, blue screen! Blue screen from the blue team. Awesome. I love the blue screen.
Though his facial expression was not like agreeing with you at that moment.
He looked in the direction of the stream booth and it was like, no thanks, guys.
Maybe next time we need like a screen here for protection.
Well, that would actually help with the noise.
Yeah, indeed. They have no clue that we're like cheering them on or even like having a little bit of fun of them when they like crash again. But you see, the difference is not that big. Darko 5 seemed to have like increased his total. He's only like trailing with 22 points at this moment. Not that
There's
much.
There's 45 seconds left. 45 seconds. So as you can see, the two guys are restarting. This is quite limited in time.
It's now or never, as they say.
Yeah. So we'd have Timothy in the link. That's only 25 seconds left.
25 seconds.
And let's do the count all together, starting from 15. Oh, they are now both back into Windows. And let's go 10, 9, 8, 6, 5, 4. And that's it. So only the benchmark from Pickaa is allowed to finish the run. Only him can finish so far. He's already qualified. It's just going to be for the Lulz, as we can say.
This bragging rights.
The bragging right, indeed. He just finished his run because he can. So that's it. We have Dark 05. He's only 12 years old, but he still managed to access this final, scoring a total point of 2,182 points, while Pickaa is scoring 2,204.
The interesting thing is, in fact, that Pickaa couldn't match the score of Dark 05 on that setup, on the first setup that Dark 05 was on. That's also like, yeah. So there's always like a little bit of luck. And I think Dark 05 maybe just lost it in the end with the multipliers. He was not high enough. It was like really, really remaining in the safe limit. Too bad.
So as you know, guys, they have to start the benchmark in the time. But this is the last one. 1080, no improvement. This is it. This is the final result. Dark 05 versus Pickaa. Congratulations, guys. Was very well done.
He's happy. He was really stressed before. These guys also had like to wake an extra 1 hour or 2 hours when the extreme guys were busy. So we were like a little bit of out of schedule. So he's like really like walking around and I probably was happy that he was already in the final. And now the stress even gets a little bit higher because now he can go for the prizes.
Indeed. And that's going to be interesting because we know from now who will go to the final for the amateur. Final for the amateur will be Pickaa against the next match that is actually coming up, and we will see who will win that one. Bigoft, what did you thought about these amateur just jumping in like this, first final for them, first competitive overclocking experience? How would you feel if that was you?
I have no clue, in fact, because I think most of us like started like slowly reading on the internet or something, or maybe even somebody coming over and just like teaching them the ropes, but that would be like in a more relaxed environment. This is like totally different. A lot of background music, people walking around, asking questions, taking pictures. So yeah, solid performance, I think, especially from Pickaa. Dark 05, maybe due to the age, not getting the max out of the system. And we already see the two new contestants like taking positions while the judge resets the entire setup, removing profiles, removing the scores. Probably going again into the bias and doing a full reset. These guys, of course, have like probably they watched the TV as well. Oh, no, you guys. No, they watch TV. So they have like reference scores already. So, yeah, something to aim for, a goal, an achievement to do. Probably we should hide that, no? From the other contestants, we should blindfold them while the other ones are busy because they have like an idea.
There's no way you can do it. Of course, they know what would the system do. But that's the thing. Pickaa can also watch what they're doing, so they will both have the exact same idea on it. So this new game will be Exmrk against Estepp, and I will just make sure that we have everything that needs to be done here.
Well, guys, I get like the final instructions from the master judge. We have to make sure that the screens are all okay. Roman like already put all my gear in my car, in his car. Would be fun. All viewers filled, man. We're ready for the final extreme. We're on the live. Sure. I have to talk, so I even can talk to you. Pretty good. So we're setting up for the second semi-final of the Amateur OC Academy here live at the Gamers Assembly in Poitiers, France. At the moment, the place is getting really packed on Easter Monday. There are like a lot of stuff going on here. Of course, all the main vendors of PC hardware are present here. Also, a lot of game companies introducing new games, new technologies. 3D printing, as usual, in the making here at the Gamers Assembly booth. If you guys have any questions about what you're seeing, what's going on, or maybe something that we need to ask to the two finalists of the Extreme Final, which will go on, let's say, in an hour, please feel free to ask. Don't forget to enter the sweepstake at the Facebook page of OverClocking-TV to enter and to gain some new hardware. I will ask Stufman to maybe link it up again on the Twitch channel so you can easily enter and participate and hopefully win something. We're almost ready to go. They're trying to figure out which player is which color before we can start.
I'm back and we'll be able to start this game very, very, very soon. Let's cue in to the judge, Timothée. Timothée, can you hear us?
Yes, of course I can hear you, Truffman. We are ready here with the two guys. We have Exmrk and Estepp on my left, Exmrk on the right. And we are ready to go for the game.
Whenever you want.
All right. Vous êtes prêts? Allez, c'est parti. 3, 2, 1, 15 minutes.
How does it feel for you guys to be back in France? Because you're like living in Toronto. Tim is like living in Taiwan.
I've been in Montreal and yeah, Timothy lives in Taiwan. It's fun. It's fun to be back here. Good cheese, good wine. But let's focus on this second semi-final here at the HWBOT World Tour 2016. This is the MSI OC Academy Final. And the two overclockers are now back in the system. Of course, they're all using XCU. They're using the Core i5, the Intel Core i5-6600K.
Yeah, indeed, a solid CPU to do like any gaming or whatever on. It's like very attractive in price and performs really good. So let's see what these guys can pull off. We also have the reference score of Darko 5 with 1096. He did on the platform of where Estepp is on now at this moment. And Exmrk, yeah, to be in the final probably has to get close to the scores of Pickaa. So 1100 plus is a necessity here. First benchmarks are running. Let's see what they can pull off.
So they are both running the benchmark at the moment. There was a question on the live chat. Who are these people? Are they completely random people? That's the guys that did qualify the amateur competition. So basically people, either gamer here at the Gamers Assembly or people attending just the first core from Exmrk is 1059. So that's just people that did attend the workshop for 30 minutes. So they didn't knew pretty much all of the all the information about overclocking before. But they got trained for 30 minutes, then they compete for 30 minutes, and then we called back the top four.
Yeah, but it is, it's like we said before, like a little bit of credit has to be given also to the mainboard manufacturers, and in this case it's MSI. Like, making out good products, Intel for making the KSQ CPUs, which are easily overclockable, and of course, like we said, with the Intel Extreme Tuning Utility tool, you can set the most important values. So we're getting the scores in. 1095 for Exmrk and 1046 now for Estepp. So he has to step up like 50 points to meet the same score that the 12-year-old Dark05 set on the similar platform. They already have like an idea, slowly increasing the multipliers, taking it easy and just letting it run. Running again, not an improvement for Exmrk, so no change in his total score. He has to go way over 1100 to meet Pickaa's score.
To Exmrk, Exmrk is now back benching 4.5, while we have 4.2 benching for Estepp.
They've been told, well, just taking it small steps, even though they had the small advantage over the previous ones, because they had no clue what CPU was in there, so normally we should see frequencies go up a little bit higher. Maybe these guys will go over 1.35 volts. I don't know.
Can't wait to see that, because so far we have no one that went over 1.3 volt in the amateur.
Yeah, it's like it is. So maybe again, credit goes to the tutors that said, say, this is a safe thing. You won't break anything. No problem. You can also do this at home without like having to run to the shop again that you toasted or smoked something. No increase there, 10 points off.
Let's
and also
out.
going for the B clock. $10.95 versus $10.73 at the moment. Exmrk versus
Estepp. Points. So they are, you know, not the best score for Exmrk. They still have to change things.
And indeed, you really have to applaud these guys that they're just doing it already. That's step one. You have to really pass by at the booth, register, I think, and then at a certain moment you will have your time slot to be taught, let's say, the basic principles of overclocking and then perform under live audience. Not something that everybody would try to do here. Void setup's running. See if he can go over 1100. Estepp the blue team, Exmrk the red.
Well, Exmrk on the left of the screen, Estepp on the right side of the screen.
He's like already nail biting, so it's not like going his way, or maybe just the nerves jumping in.
So let's check out the first score for Exmrk. Exmrk will have 1090, so not improving his score of 1095, while 1092 for Estepp is actually a good improvement, improvement of about 20 points.
Yeah, and it also beat Dark05's best score, which was, what, 1086? That was what it was. So he has found something and probably not going too wild on the voltages, slowly increasing the beat clock. Now he's going one multiplier higher. I don't know if he can pull this one off. The platform didn't run anything above 4.5, I think, before. Nope.
Oh, blue screen!
He can do the boop, 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 boop.
Bruh. I still need a jingle because I will lose my voice at screaming this blue screen.
Really? Maybe you should just tape it and just have like
a power
sample. Just push it on.
We are 9 minutes left in this first match of the second semi-final for the MSI OC Academy. This is the screen from Exmrk, soon to be giving a score at 4.5 GHz. Still some margin, no limit is kicking in. 1078, still not a good better score. Still not a better score.
What will it do? Raise the multiplier, raise the P-clock? That's the question. Just go for the volts.
He's like going all around, just increasing the V-core, but the V-core won't give you more points.
Although I have to tell you something about Cinebench, maybe. Cinebench, you can run, and sometimes you just don't change anything, and you just run a little higher V-core. Usually it remains a little bit more stable during the benchmark. Sometimes you have a higher output. I don't know who can explain me that. I have no clue how it works. But it happens. Sometimes a little bit more V-core, and that benchmark can help. But this is like raw clocks that these guys are doing now, just getting the highest clocks possible. And trying 44 again, maybe higher P-clock, raise the encore, and go for it again.
So this is it. They have to max out the turbo boost power max to not have the current limit trolling kicking it at this moment. That's the issue that the contestant just before had, and they are still quite conservative on the core voltage, like 1.27. This is still low for even amateur. I think they got told like it doesn't. If you go too high, it will not work anyway. So they're just trying to just not restart.
And it's like we said, the temperatures are like really low. So usually we have seen, especially with the Pentium ones last year, they were like always like thermal throttling.
Yeah.
They went 105 degrees all the time. It was like something will have to break. Luckily it didn't, but these guys are really more conservative.
Did Exmrk running, starting XTU, waiting for it to happen?
But really pushing it now, because this is the highest frequency I have seen this setup like almost completing the benchmark.
Setup of Estepp at 4.56 GHz. There's no limits kicking in. The CPU utilization seems fine. And the processor cache ratio is processor cache is at 4.3 still, and for both of the overclockers, so that should be
Wow.
Yeah. 11 and 10 score improvement for Estepp.
The difference with these guys is like from last year that you remembered with Orion 24 and the guy that won, they were like constantly taking notes as well. They were like writing down, what did I change? What works? Which multiplier? Which voltages? They always had like, if they changed even to the setup, they could like fall back to these notes. And that's something that maybe these guys are like forgetting. Maybe they will do it in the final. No, I have no clue. But at least we had like a, the fact that the platforms are like almost matched. Like the best score from Pickaa was 1122-ish, something like this. So they should be able to match, let's say, both platforms are equal performance.
They both use the exact same configuration. They both use the MSI Gaming Pro Carbon. The motherboard D170, of course, the chipset. The Core i7-6600K. The Core i5-6600K. DDR4 from Clef, the Crass memory. There's the all-in-one cooler on top of it, so same cooler. They all use the same PSU, the Seasonic 760W Platinum Edition. They all display the system on the Streamcom BC1. Oh, we have a crash from your Estepp.
Too bad for you, there was no blue screen. Setup just rebooted. So Exmrk still going strong, above 4.5. Let's see if it can match or even beat the current score, because I think his, one of his first runs was like the highest one.
Yeah, almost, and, yeah.
And he hasn't like much improved afterwards. So let's see if he can go. Ah, no. Still below. He needs to figure out something else to get it like running.
It's like, you can see, it's like, oh, where I should go? Which one I should push? You can feel like, okay, I know I have to change something, but I don't know exactly why and what.
They also have to think, like, they got like taught like yesterday, or maybe they were already here on Friday. I don't know. Was there Friday?
No, Friday, no, nothing Friday. Was open. Nothing was open. Just
so
only, Saturday.
So from Saturday on. Yeah. And maybe these guys have been, like, been gaming for 48 hours in a row. Like typical LAN party stuff.
Like we all used to do, eh?
Yeah, indeed.
Estepp, that is the current leader, is back in XTU, going to 1.4 megahertz for the reference clock. The core voltage, come on, you can push that almost at 1.3 without any problem. That would be fine. Okay, trying to go 104.4, push all the limits for the turbo to the maximum, go to 4.4 gigahertz, so that will give you a nice total frequency of 4.6 gigahertz. Potential cache ratio. The other side with Exmrk running the benchmark, soon to have a score. Wait for it. And 1091, not improving its previous scores, still 4 points off for it. There's 3 minutes left in this second semifinal.
See if we can improve here. It's so much fun that these two cores are like really so close to one another. So there's like not much room left. Something that we usually don't see with the extreme overclocking. Usually some people have like 200 or 300 megahertz more. Here it's like almost all the same. 4.5, 4.6, and that's where it goes. I really have to applaud to Estepp because he's like pushing the setup way higher than what Dark05 could do. Like beating him at almost 200 megahertz, and might could just top it the best score of Pickaa as well. Only needing like 13 points.
So we have Estepp benching at 4.58 gigahertz, while we have Exmrk benching at 4.57.
Oh, getting closer there.
11.17, improving his score. Estepp is getting 7 more points.
Tim didn't change the platforms, did he? Every setup stayed at the same position?
Yes.
But that's always interesting to see that some guys couldn't like perform well on one setup, do better on another, and these guys just reversed the roles. The setup that didn't perform that well in the previous semi-final is now leading all of a sudden. But just trying to get everything right.
So both of the overclockers still benching. So Estepp is benching now at 4.6 gigahertz. He decreased a little bit his frequency, while Exmrk increased the frequency as well in the last minute and 30 seconds at 4.63 gigahertz. So these, if these pass, the score should be a bit bigger than what we have right now on the scoreboard.
Indeed.
But keep in mind, there's only 1 minute and 10 seconds left. So if one of them crash, it might take a while. Oh, that's it. We add a crash from Estepp, so it's almost, that's going to be difficult for him to restart the system, get to XTU, change the settings. Oh! He got the blue screen at the very end for Estepp. Let's wait if we can see the score of Exmrk. 11.18, so he's now taking the lead.
The lead in the final seconds, which is like always interesting.
And that's 1 point difference between the two guys. This is extremely close, extremely close. There is 30 seconds left in this game.
The heat is on, as they say. Really? Can they still like do all the timings so quickly?
20 seconds.
20 seconds.
It should be possible.
15, 14,
is not 13,
12, 11, 10.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bon, c'est fini. Bravo.
The last thing that is running is the one from Exmrk, but he's already winning, so we know that he will move on to the final. He just wants to let the...
We still need to swap the setups.
They still need to... Oh my god, sorry for that. They still need to swap the setup, of course, but we know that there's only 1 point difference
point
between
difference.
Them.
It's nothing.
It's nothing, yeah.
It's really nothing. And... It improved.
And he improved in score. So that's interesting. So now you have 2 points advantage over his opponent.
Yeah. So that's pretty, pretty cool. So Pickaa did the best score on let's say, the red platform. And Estepp did his best on the other one. Both platforms really matched. CPUs now reaching similar frequencies. So let's see if these guys can do the same. And I don't know. I couldn't place any bets on who is going to win this one. There is almost no difference. Fingers crossed.
Let's make sure when the overclockers are ready, tuning in to Timothée, yes. The judge of this competition.
Yep, overclockers are ready. We are ready to go. All right. 3, 2, 1, go.
And they are back. 15 minutes to get the best score in XTU. They have 2 points difference. Anything can happen.
Indeed.
So that means the two systems are very close to each other at the moment in terms of performances.
Nico, they look like a little bit more confident now, like straight raising the multiplier up to 4.5, 4.6. So not wasting any time like figuring out what is going on. Both know that the platforms perform similar. So now it's just finding the right voltage setting for the right multiplier and hopefully the benchmark finishes. It's still a long benchmark though.
But it's already running at 4.6 gigahertz.
Yeah.
So if he's putting out a score like this, it should be like over almost 1100, pretty much around that frequency, that scoring. So now there are now both running the benchmark. So we have 4.6 GHz for Exmrk and we have 4.48 GHz for Estepp. The things that we have to look at are the small throttling limits in the bottom just above the scoreboard. If there is the thermal throttling limit, that means the CPU is too hot to run. If there's the power limit throttling, that means there is too much power being used by the CPU, and the current limit, there is too much current being drawn by the CPUs. Yeah. So the first one to finish this XTU will set the first core of the second match of the second semifinal.
It should be both close to 1100 or even surpassing it.
Can't wait to see what will be the first one. The first one will be from... Here, from Estepp. Estepp will be the first one to submit the score. 1093, still close to 1100, but can do better than that for sure. Oh, there was something happening. The system might have crashed in a way, because the benchmark is still running, but it's actually not putting any load to the system. It's and stuck to this.
Figure it out. Magic Control Alt Delete. You cannot select.
It crashed the system. It did crash the system. It's trying to get out of it. I'm just gonna restart the complete system.
The judge just powering off the power supply, just like that. Don't try this at home.
It's off.
Don't try this at home.
4.5 gigahertz for Estepp. Let's see if I can improve his score of 1093. that still have 12 minutes. It's already 3 minutes we're in the game. This is going quite fast, like times fly here.
But these guys have learned from their previous, let's say, experience on the platform. Because with the other two, we just saw them like slowly build up the same thing again, because they had no reference of what the other setup could do. These guys are like, oh yeah, 11:02. So putting on the pressure on Estepp.
That's the first time. That's the first of this amateur that get two score above 1100 as well.
Yeah. Do we have a new Orion 24 coming up?
Would be interesting to see that. Because Orion 24, for the guests that just joined us on Twitch, was one of the amateur from last year and is now competing in the extreme. This year, it will actually be competing against Zizulio for the bronze final here for the extreme, the Master Overclocking Arena. And that match would be actually right after these ones. We're going to take a break and that's going to be the match of Orion 24 and Zizulio.
We go first the losers final between brackets and then the big final. Okay, cool.
So both running XTU at the moment. Let's see.
Similar clocks.
Similar clocks, 4.5, 4.5. Temperature is 52 for Exmrk and it's about 53 for Estepp. So that's super, super close. The score will probably be close as well.
Indeed. I'm really glad we're running i5 now this year. You still remember the Pentiums? You also did the Pentiums in Latin America. So then it takes even longer, the benchmark. And it's like, whoa, we have to wait. We have to sit this one out. Finished. We just aborted the benchmark and just rerunning again, trying to get a little bit higher.
The score of Exmrk soon to appear on the screen. You have to look at the current score on the top left of the screen. And 1181, so that's good. That's the first score. That's a good placeholder. You still get a decent amount of points for that. Keep in mind that the person there will only be a final for these amateurs, and the third and fourth place will be designated because by the total amount of points.
Ah, okay.
So it's still good to have a placeholder to put your score on the map.
Yeah. Total then for Exmrk. Getting a slow update. Both setups running again. 4.6 and one close to 4.6. That's really
looking at the screen and looking at the computer, it's like, please pass, please pass.
Do not crash. Don't dare to crash.
So Estepp score 11:20, so he's improving his score, and this is actually the best score of this. He's actually beating the best score from Exmrk just before.
Yeah, but it's so tight. It's 1 point and 2 points further on there was Pickaa with 11:22. So yeah. Will be a very interesting.
We just got a blue screen from Estepp. Blue screen from Estepp. But the Exmrk just submitted a good score just before the blue screen from Estepp at 10:94, if I remember correctly. He was improving his score. Not beating his opponent, but still improving on his score.
But he already knows that he has to go to 1100-ish as well. Otherwise, it will not work out. Good enough, though, at the moment, I think, for a solid third spot.
Blue screen from Exmrk.
They can do like synchronous one, no? They should do that together. Estepp thinking hard, what else can I change? What can I do? Secure my
There's
spot
only
for the final.
7 minutes and 50 seconds left in this second leg as well.
Alexiu recovering, going in, changing all the values. Raise the B clock this time.
Trying to put the core voltage. Okay, come on, you can push it. You can push it even higher than that.
Yeah. Oh.
1.29.
They're closing it. Closing it. Oh.
He 44 multiplier. 45 or 44.
Yeah, just to figure out first what the total CPU speed will be. Yep, 45. Should run a little bit higher, guys. Come on, you can do this.
Exmrk is pushing all the knobs to the maximum. He's at 4.2 GHz, going up to almost 4.6, 4.59. Would be a decent run if this managed to go through. Both and Exmrk and Estepp benching at the moment.
Really close. So indeed, I think to win it, this one, Exmrk really has to push above 4.6. That's the only way he can get close. Unless the B-clock helps him now with a higher memory frequency to get like a little bit more efficient run and yeah, but it's 26 points difference. Not much, but that's a lot to do in a run of XTU.
Soon the score from Estepp. Let's see if he can improve his score. 11:15. It doesn't improve his score so far, but he's still in the lead at the moment. This score from Exmrk that will soon come in would be quite interesting to see, because that can change a lot of things. If he's scoring 11:20 as well, he's getting back in the lead. If he's scoring 11:19, he's getting back in the lead as well.
It should be 11:00. Ah, oh, come on.
10:90. So there's definitely something that he did not think through. Of course, the reference clock is influencing on the memory frequency as well. The memory frequency. XTU depends on the memory frequency for some of the calculation workloads.
Yeah, it's really a tweakable benchmark, and it has its lovers and its haters. The thing is, like, on extreme overclocking, you can kill your CPU because it's so strenuous on all the cores that are being loaded. But that's part of the game, of course. Of course, for these amateur overclocking, there's like loads of headroom still to go in regarding temperature and voltage. They can easily push to 1.35-ish. There shouldn't be like any problem. These CPUs can handle that. But you have to think about it. That's the first thing. You have to be aware. And if your tutor maybe not say failed yesterday, but said, keep it low, man. Don't kill anything. That's the way to go.
A step soon to finish the benchmark.
Let's starting to pray already.
Four. 11:26. So. Can see 6 point improvements in his score. That would be very tight for Exmrk to catch up, especially because Estepp did 11:17 maximum point on the same platform that Exmrk is using now.
And that's also the highest score now for the blue, for the setup on the right, indeed. For our right, for the other ones, for the viewers on the left. So indeed, he beat Pika's score already with 4 points. Running less than 4 minutes to go. I could easily do like a few more runs. Hopefully not without getting the need to reboot the system. Come on, guys. :22:11 versus :22:43. Doesn't seem big, but at these limited frequencies, it's a huge step. But Exmrk really should be also doing scores 1100-ish.
Score is from Estepp. 11:27. One point improvement. Soon the score from Exmrk. Can Exmrk reach go above the 1100 mark? 10:96. 4 point improvement. Still below 1100. That might hold him back on getting the claim for the spot and go to the access the final for the amateur.
And increases the B clock, leaves the multiplier alone because he knows the CPU is like running on its tiptoes. But trying to get a little bit more performance, a little bit more speed there. He's approaching the 1.35 volts now. Just playing.
Finally,
it safe.
Someone put 1.33 volts, more than 1.3 volts. That's good. That will be CD. So on the screen, you have Exmrk benching at 4.6 GHz at 1.33 volts. And on the other side, we do have our second contestant, Estepp, benching at 4.68 and 1.29 volts.
Yeah, they also raised the encore frequency as well, right? Almost closing in on 4.6, while Exmrk remains a little bit more conservative, 4.33 encore speed. Both runs almost over halfway, approaching the end. Let's see if Exmrk can really nail 1100 plus. It should be at these frequencies. Should be able to top it.
Can you do it?
1 minute Estepp. 45 to go.
11.22, not improving his previous score. Let's see. 11.04, finally, 1100. The barrier is passed. Finally, Exmrk can go above 1100. Finally, there's 1 minute and 30 seconds left. Might this be too late?
I don't know. It'll be a tight call because I didn't really time how long the XTU runs, but it would be close to a minute, I think, at least.
I guess 40 seconds.
40 seconds? It really feels like a long time. You see only it crashed.
That it crashed, so you're going to have to restart the system.
Estepp starting to look at the setup of his competitor to see what's going on, having his little fun. Well, the other one crashed. Yeah, I think rebooting the setup and getting XTU to run again will be out of time, I think. Because XTU always recovers after a crash, but it takes a while before it's like really loaded. He can try, of course.
40 seconds left in this second match of the final. And here we go, 30 seconds from now. We have the communication open with Xiala, the judge. We have Exmrk soon to do a score. 11.22 for Exmrk. This is huge. This is 20 points more. He's getting so close that he's actually passing his opponent, if I'm right, if I do the calculation correctly.
Well, you mean Pickaa or
Estepp? So here we go. It's over. The benchmark cannot be run anymore. Exmrk at 11.22 benchmark point that still need to be updated on the scoreboard to have the final ranking.
Let's see what happens.
Let's see what can be done.
These are usually the best moments when you're like, they just pressed start just before the end of time, and then we still have to sit it out because the benchmark was run and it crashed. So it's over. We have to see the total. What happens here? PJ enters the total. So I assume Estepp took the win. No, not sure yet. No. I think that score was from Estepp as well, I think, Truth.
That's me doing some misunderstanding in here. So this is the final scoreboard. I have...
This is what happens when you don't sleep enough. I really have to applaud you guys that you stayed up watching our gear at the overclocking booth, filling up viewers in the middle of night. We had some 6 hours sleep a day. You guys didn't have that much, I think.
I don't think so. I don't think I had 6 hours of sleep for the complete weekend.
Yeah, so I would be like totally drained. So big applause to you guys as well, that you're always providing us with everything that we need and even looking after our stuff while we're like snoring in bed. It's like it is, True. Really. Good job, man.
Thank you. And this would not be possible without you, Ligoft, being here for the commentary. And so we know exactly who will go to the next for the amateur final to happen in the next few minutes. The amateur final will feature Pickaa, that did score a total number of points of 2204. And it will go against Estepp, 2244 points. I do hope that Pickaa was watching his opponent prepare for what's going to be coming. My dear Ligoft, we will take a break because we have to pack everything from the amateur for the extreme to come in. The next match to happen here at the HWBOT World Tour 2016 Europe here at the Gamers Assembly will be for the Master Overclocking Arena final, we will take the bronze final. We will have Zizulio against...
Who was it? Orion 24.
Orion 24. Orion 24, one of the amateurs from last year that is now competing in the Extreme League. So we have Zizulio, Orion 24, the first bronze final of this Extreme for the Master Overclocking Arena 2016. Then we will have the final of the amateur. The amateur will be featuring our friends Pickaa against Estepp. And then after that, we will have the final of the Extreme of the Master Overclocking Arena featuring two German guys, Dankop, currently number one in the world, number one overclocker in the world on HWBOT, featuring his, teammate, but his friend, Bullshooter from Germany as well.
Indeed. So it's a derby, like Bayern München against Düsseldorf or whatever big teams they are playing in Germany. So it will be really interesting to see what these guys can pull off. And of course, one has taught the other guy a lot of tips and tweaks, and I know Bullshooter has benched a lot together with Dankop at Dankop's place, so yeah, maybe it's time. We only know that Bullshooter has the advantage in CPU, so the draw of the benchmark will be really crucial and how both will dial in the memory.
Guys, we'll take a short break and we'll find right back for the first bronze final of this Extreme here at the MSI Master Overclocking Arena on the HWBOT World Tour 2016.
Okay, see you, bye.